Nervous tissue. It comes together to form nervous system of the body, whose main components are the big boss, the brain, and the spinal cord. So what exactly does the nervous system do? It takes all important decisions for you about what the body should do, how it should look like, and so on and so on. And since this is such an important system, you would have guessed that the cells in the system would be super special too. And you are right. The nervous tissue is comprised of very, very special cells called neurons and glial cells. Now, the work of the nervous system is to, one, sense stimuli like touch, smell, taste, sight, and hearing, and two, send impulses across the body through electrical signals. Now, neurons look like typical cells with a cell body and a nucleus. Now, this is an important diagram from an exam point of view, and we'll make it very easy. If you ask me for an analogy, as you can see, it looks something like a tree with branches, the trunk, and the roots. The branches are the dendrites. The trunk is the axon, and the roots are called the axon terminals. You heard that word before, right? What exactly happens in a train or a bus terminal? Trains or buses come in and go out. Similarly, at the axon terminals, important information through electrical impulses transferred from one neuron to the other. They actually high jump across from one neuron to the other through the small space called the synapse. And what about glial cells? They aren't as famous as neurons, right? In fact, all the attention is stolen by the nerve cells. No one even talks about glia, that is plural for glial cells. But the fact is that there are 10 to 50 times more glial cells in our body than nerve cells. But neurons cannot even function properly without the glial cells. They are the personal secretaries of the neuron and do a lot of chores for the neurons. They hang around in bunches all around the nerve cells. In Greek, actually, glia means glue, the glue of the nervous system, although only this is partially accurate. They do surround the neurons and support them, but along with that, they supply nutrients and oxygen to the neurons. They insulate one neuron from the other, and they also destroy pathogens and help in protecting these neurons. Many nerve fibers bundle up together with the connective tissue and make up a nerve. The nerve impulses generated allow us to actually move our muscles. So this nice, neat interplay of nervous and muscular tissue is fundamental to movement. You can clearly see how different tissues come together in such perfect coordination to give you the gift of life. If you like this video and want to watch many, many more amazing videos like these, like and subscribe to our channel now.